In 2012, a group of Toyota employees established the pro bono group Cartivator and began work on the SD00 shortly after. This was a scale model prototype of a flying car that the company had envisioned creating. They successfully ran driving and hovering tests with the prototype only 6 months later. Still, before they could work on the real deal, they needed to scale it up first. And so, the production of the SD01 had begun, and the new group, SkyDrive, would arise. SkyDrive was the new edition of Cartivator and would oversee the production of the SD series, such as the new SD01 project. Information on this new prototype is sparse, but it was a very early design with a metal frame, 4 wheels, 2 seats, a steering wheel, and 4 rotors. However, tests were a success, so SkyDrive was able to raise funding, shake hands, and make friends. So they leaped into making their goal a reality. Now you know the story, so let's get to the good stuff. The SD03, and the current project being developed, the SDXX. The SD03 made its first public demonstration in 2020 and featured a much more commercial design than the previous prototypes. The single-seat design resembles contemporary eVTOLs and measures around 13 feet long and 11 feet wide. 4 rotors are evenly split between each corner. Each rotor is powered by its own motor as a fail-safe mechanism. A pilot flew for 4 minutes around 1 hectare of land during the demonstration, while a computer handled the flight stability and safety. At this point, SkyDrive has shaped up to be the leader of Japan's eVTOL scene, with many sponsorships, such as Bandai Namco and Mitsubishi. For a future project, Suzuki has teamed up with SkyDrive for a special project that looks like it could be the SDXX. Suzuki will handle things like business and technology research and development, and help with mass producing SkyDrive's next project. This means SkyDrive is left to focus on creating the best compact 2-seater eVTOL possible. Although the SDXX is still in development, hence the placeholder name, it still boasts a much more striking image than its predecessor, the SD03. It adds another seat to the mix for 2 people to enjoy a ride in the glass-covered cabin. And because of its 3 wheels and land driving capabilities, it technically falls into the category of a flying car rather than an eVTOL. This is an interesting decision, considering that they are trying to balance not only a working flying machine, but then make it hybrid transportation to boot. That's why many people believe that Suzuki's partnership is to help with the SDXX and logistics. In terms of specs, the new addition to SkyDrive's flying family doubles the number of rotors of previous prototypes to 8. It's designed to lift a maximum takeoff weight of around 1,100 pounds. It can reach heights of up to 1,600 feet, have a maximum flying speed of about 60 miles per hour, and fly for approximately half an hour. Touching down and cruising is possible, of course. You can expect max speeds to reach upwards of 37 miles per hour, ranging from between 12 and 18 miles, depending on use. Whether SkyDrive and Suzuki are aiming this product at personal consumers or air taxi services could be anyone's guess, but they have started plans for tackling entering the air taxi landscape. Do you want to follow up when new information comes out before 2025? What did you like or dislike about SkyDrive's timeline? And be sure to stick around for our honorable mentions. With the appearance of an angry wasp looking for vengeance, the Cavorite X5 Hybrid eVTOL employs an aggressive-looking split-wing design, despite being built around system redundancy and passenger safety. The high-efficiency gas engine is based on the Chevrolet LS series of V8 engines. It's supported by an electric motor, driving the sizable rear-mounted pusher prop along at a rate of 215 miles per hour. During vertical takeoff and landing, arrays of ducted fans within the dual wings turn the X5 into a 16-rotor, self-balancing multicopter, capable of hovering in the air on a dime. It can carry up to 5 people inside.
Thanks. Urban air mobility is also on the mind of another company, Volocopter.
Its development was part of the Single European Sky ATM Research Program, a public-private joint effort to overhaul European airspace for future crewless aircraft. The Velocity made its first demonstration flight amidst regular air traffic in Helsinki and later in Stuttgart, Germany. The Volocopter flight in Germany was the highlight of a two-day event called Vision Smart City, experiencing the mobility of the future today. The company just secured $55 million in funding, which is helping the aircraft achieve its goal for a commercial launch within the next 3 years. This jet-powered glider built for one has to be one of the most stylish ways to get around. With a jet engine powering the glider from takeoff, after adequate altitude is achieved, the engine is turned off, and it can be flown as an unpowered glider. It's only 7 feet long, but has a wingspan of 32 feet. You pilot the glider from a prone position at the center. Turning is as simple as shifting your weight and using a few handles to control the rudder. Underneath where you lay, there's a jet engine with considerable separation from the walls of the engine pod in order to permit better cooling and prevent excessive fire risk. Most of the glider is made from fiber-reinforced plastic with a wooden skeleton, making the thing rather light, weighing only 150 pounds. The glider can reach speeds up to 75 miles an hour, but has a passenger weight limit around 110 pounds. Unfortunately for us, if you enjoyed this video, you could help us out by hitting the like button, subscribe, and keep up to date on future posts.